Hi, so my friend got us tickets to a Bulls versus Clippers game. So I am heading there and I'm going to vlog, and it is 30 degrees on, and friends, just wait till you see what I have on. Anything for a fit, right? I have really just been finishing my book, A Bronzeville Basement. That's one of two for my January book launch. And I have basically just been wearing a sweatshirt and sweatpants around the house all day. So I haven't vlogged much outside of just the progress of my book, but here I am, I'm back. I'm excited for the content that I'm about to get. It's really cold outside. I really played myself. My parents would judge me. So let me zip up and make this a bit of a better decision. Bye! Zipping up 100% helped. I just really love being in Chicago because I have a bus pass this week that, of course, I purchased for $28 for the week, and my friend lives really fucking far, so I'm running behind because I laid in bed with my heating pad on for way too long. So I call her and I'm like, oh, what time do we need to be there? Because I'm trying to decide if I'm gonna Uber or take the train, and she said like it don't matter, so definitely hop on in the train. So technically free, I mean, like, when I get this bus pass, maybe like 3 days ago, and I've definitely gotten like $28 worth versus a $15 Uber, so I'm excited. Although an Uber would have been better for my outfit, but honestly, I mean, like, everyone says this when they have on a ridiculous outfit in the cold, but it's not too bad. It's really not. Don't try this at home, friends. I am super excited. The cool thing about basketball is that, like, I understand it. Like, I like get football a little bit. I know it's something about like the downs, but I don't always like follow. But basketball, oh yeah, your girl can follow that one. Very, very excited. This is very random, but did y'all ever see a license plate and it like remind you of something? So like, I always see like ZU6. And that like makes me think of my lying sister Gabby, or like ZU4, that makes me think of Robin. Am I weird? Do you all see license plates and think of people? Almost to the train. It's not a bad walk. It's like an 8-minute walk to the train. The next question is the train gonna be here? Do any of you live off of the Green Line? Because the Green Line sucks butthole big time. I do miss the red line. The big difference between the green and the red line would be if I were to get to the train on the red line, at the most, on a bad situation, it would say that the train is 5 minutes away, and that is just like bizarre and intense. On the green line, if you get there and it says 8 minutes to the next train, count your goddamn blessings, because that's good. So it's just like less frequent. For sure. Let me show you all this real quick. I hope I don't miss the train trying to show this, but this is the Forum. I want to get like better video in daytime, but it's an old performance space. But they just recently put this new painting up here. So it's like, I don't know. It's very cool. It's like just the old like venues, Vince venues. I know they've been trying to save it for a really long time. It's open actually during this thing called Open House Chicago. That's every, what, October? So super cute. I just got to the Green Line. It says that the train is 17 minutes away. So I'm gonna see if this bus that takes you to the red line is close. Got my venture ready. I mean, what did I freaking tell you people? The green line is out of control. So now I'm actually going to walk back. I'm going to walk backwards to catch the 3. I'm going to take the 3 to the loop. And I don't know if I'm going to hop on the red line or stay on the buses, but yo, the green line is not okay. How is the next train 19 minutes away on a Saturday at the end of the decade? Don't you know that people are partying? Don't you know that people have to live? Man! CTA, seriously. I'm serious. The green line is like fucked up. And I don't like it. It's not fair. I live off the green line. We live off the green line. People live off the green line. Why is it 19 minutes away? Oop, and I hear, hold on, let me look, I'm gonna be mad if it's, oh, no, that's going the opposite direction. I was gonna say, okay, get into the 3. Get into the money. I say get into the 3. This is crazy. So I am in the loop, walking to the red line now. You know, just quite the fucking journey, but it's okay. Almost to where I'm going. Well, the first spot, we're not even heading to the game yet. Heading to my friend's house for the pregame. The city's beautiful.
This is Clark and Division.
Still on the train, but I'm very close now. My skin is popping.
My life.
I'm so upset. You can't see me, but I made it safely. But my phone died. I was vlogging.
I'm taking this.
Like to be my sunshine, nigga. Touch my game, we gon' turn this shit to Columbine.
Beyond, hey, I'm beyond all that fuck shit. Ain't no telling what. Hey, said I'm beyond.
I'm in the legs, I get fitted with some bitches from the west side, east coast, nigga. Reppin' north side, never was the host. Bitch, I'm on my home side. Fuck a nigga.
We're going to the penthouse, I say. Rich big pussy.
Where is 7?
Oh, sorry. Wow, do you see this fucking melanin? We're going to 97?
Not to the penthouse.
Not to the penthouse.
Are we going the right way?
I don't mean to be loud, but we're going to the penthouse.
Excuse me, we're going to the penthouse.
Sorry.
So.
Wait, tell him. I ain't gonna tell him. You tell him. So what?
Penthouse, darling. Let me up and treat me as such.
Get out of here. I don't know where we just entered from, but.
Okay. We entered Narnia.
Help!
Going up to the angel.
So she fancy. Thank you.
Oh, look at us.
Mom, I'm mom.
Mom, so sweet.
Settle into my life. That's literally my motto for 2020.
It's my stepsister. Mom, so sweet, Tom.
I know. I know.
My night is just beginning, people. The Bulls won, and now we are at Joe's on Wee Street. The party is not over. Okay, girls, so it's like 2:30 and my night is officially over. What a fun time. I spent $7 on an Uber to the United Center, and I was spending $10 on an Uber to go home, like $17 for as much liquor as I drank, and the fact that I was in a box seat at fucking United Center. Winning! Bye! Okay, I gotta find my Uber. It is 3 o'clock. My Uber driver literally just woke me up. He goes, Kyel, you're home. I go, where are my friends? And it took me way too long to remember that I got an Uber by myself. Whew. Wow. What a day.